Hello everyone, my name is Harsh Purohit and I am working in Research and Development Group, Hitachi, Japan. Today I will be presenting about deep autoencoding GMM-based unsupervised anomaly detection in acoustic signals and its hyperparameter optimization. This work is done in collaboration with the team at Hitachi. So this is the content for the today's presentation, in which we first discuss the existing approach and challenges with it. Then we will discuss about the proposed method. After that, we will see the evaluation result on real industrial fan data. And finally, we will conclude the talk. So first of all, we will discuss some background. Factory machinery is prone to failure or breakdown, which results in significant expenses to companies, and it may give some defective products and delay in overall process. So recently there is a rising interest for smart factory maintenance using different sensors like vibration, temperature and pressure, etc. But apart from these sensors, recently acoustic sensing is also becoming attractive because of the following reasons. The first one is it requires no or very less change in the existing infrastructures, and the deployment is very easy and it is cheap and affordable. So existing unsupervised anomaly detection methods can be broadly classified into three groups. First is reconstruction based method, which includes principal component analysis and deep autoencoder based algorithms. Second one is cluster analysis based method. It includes Gaussian mixture models and K-means clustering. And third one is one-class classification approach, in which we try to find out the discriminatory boundary, and based on that we can decide the anomaly. So one-class support vector machine is it's one of the main example. However, there is a one recent technique which tries to include reconstruction based method as well as clustering method. Its name is a deep autoencoding Gaussian mixture model. In short, we can call it DAGMM. And DAGMM model utilizes deep autoencoder to generate low dimensional representation. And then this representation can be further fed to Gaussian mixture model for density estimation task. So as we discussed, DAGMM model consists of two subnetworks. The first one is compression subnetwork and second one is estimation subnetwork. And the parameters of these two networks are optimized simultaneously in end-to-end fashion that we will see in the next part. But there are some challenges also to make it end-to-end. To do the training in end-to-end fashion. So first we will discuss the challenges and then we will discuss the proposed approach to overcome those challenges. As we discussed in the last section, DAGMM consists of two subnetworks. First one is compression subnetwork. Compression subnetwork is a usual deep autoencoder, and during training we found out that anomalies cannot be projected similarly on the low dimensional space, so it is better to give the reconstruction error as well as compressed vector for the next network, that is estimation network. And if we see the structure of the estimation network, it is a usual multi-layer network, and it takes input as a concatenated vector z, which is comprises of compressed vector zc and reconstruction error zr from the autoencoder, and it tries to come up with a mixture membership prediction in terms of energy function for this input. And here we are trying to use neural network for GMM instead of traditional EM algorithm because we require end-to-end training. What do I mean by end-to-end training is clear from this slide. Here we take both the networks and try to calculate the error based on the minimizing the energy function EZ, which is described below the slide, and reconstruction error for from the autoencoder. And in this manner, we try to train the network, both the networks, compressed as well as estimation network, simultaneously. However, there are some difficulties. We found out that two hyperparameters like GMM components and size of reduced dimension is very important. And if we change those two hyperparameters for the networks in the network structure, then accuracy varies very largely. And further, if we plot the accuracy versus those two hyperparameters like GMM component and size of reduced dimension, we can clearly see that there is a one sweet spot which gives us the highest accuracy for anomaly detection task. So in the next section, we will propose the method from which we can decide these two hyperparameters, and we can have a highest accuracy for anomaly detection. So this is the overview of proposed method. We will introduce one block called hyperparameter tuning block, which comprises of two blocks. First is to determine the GMM components, and second one is to determine the size of reduced dimension. So first of all, selection of GMM components, or determine the correct number of GMM components. So as in the left hand side figure, if we project our original normal data in 2D and then we do the group clustering, then we can find that we have four clusters. But if we do very accurate clustering and overfit the data, then we can have six number of clusters. So how to do group clustering? For that, we can use calculation of gap statistics. This is a simple example for calculation of gap statistic for two clusters. We can calculate within cluster dispersion as shown in the formula of decay with Euclidean distance, and denote represents the dispersion for original data. In our case, it is data with two clusters, and DRK represents the dispersion with reference data. In our case, it is uniform distribution. And then if we calculate the GK as shown in the formula of gap statistic, and we plot it with respect to different number of clusters K, then we can say that gap statistic is larger at the best number of clusters. So for our data, same thing. If we calculate the gap curve first and then capture the maximum change in the gap curve, then we can have a optimal number of clusters for the given data. So how to find the bending point on the given curve. So this is a simple algorithm with these five steps, in which first we will normalize the values. Second, we find the difference with line y equal to x, and the difference curve is shown in the figure B with dashed line. And then we will take some threshold, and with this, with that threshold, if we find some local maxima, then we will declare it as a global maxima for or a bending point in our case for a given curve. So same thing for second hyperparameter, which is size of reduced dimension. In PCA, we can determine the variance contribution for every component, and then if we consider number of components required to maintain the maximum variance in the data, in other words, if we find the bending point on the curve obtained by cumulative eigenvalue for every component in PCA, we can have a very optimal estimate of size of reduced dimension. So this is the best combination for our case, in which GM components are chosen as 4 and dimension of compression is chosen as 6. This is the block diagram for training phase, in which first we will decide the both hyperparameters, and then we will train the DAGMM network simultaneously. This is the testing phase, in which we will take the trained DAGMM network on the normal data, and then we will for a given input sample, we will calculate the energy, and if the energy is greater than predefined threshold eta, then we can say that given sample is anomalous. Now we will see the evaluation part, and we evaluated our results on the real industrial fan data. In the evaluation, we took 6 different kind of industrial fans. These fans are different in terms of size and its design. And for a normal case, we kept a 50 centimeter distance between mic and the fan. And for abnormal case, we deliberately damaged the fan and recorded the signals. These are some more experimental details. 16-bit audio signals sampled at 16 kilohertz in a reverberant environment. And the feature extraction technique comprises of a log mass spectrogram, and we took 64 filter banks. And these are some more details regarding encoder-decoder structure and estimation network. This is the result comparison with existing techniques. If we see that single deep autoencoder or GMM based method is not so good, and if we combine the compression and data estimation method like PCA and GMM or DAE and GMM, then also results are not so good. But if we combine both compression as well as data estimation method with the best hyperparameter optimization, then we can achieve the highest accuracy. Now we will conclude our talk that in this presentation, we proposed the DAGMM based unsupervised anomaly detection to audio signals with automatic hyperparameter optimization technique. The gap statistics and cumulative eigenvalues were used to optimize the hyperparameters, and this technique provides the highest accuracy for unsupervised anomaly detection. Thank you for your attention, and if you have questions, please send me an email.